In this module, we're going to talk about acid-base equilibria and what's called the common ion effect. So the idea is this. This is nothing new at this point. So let's say we have a weak acid, hydrofluoric acid, in solution. Let's say we have 1 liter of solution and it's 0.150 molar hydrofluoric acid. The Ka for hydrofluoric acid is 7.1 times 10 to the minus 4th. Well, we can do the normal calculations, and you should check me and make sure we get the same answers. We can find out the concentration of everything in there, the pH. So I get a quadratic. 5% rule doesn't quite work, so I had to solve the quadratic. I get two roots for x. One was negative, so throw that out. That's nonsense. And the other one is good. So we know x, about 0.01, 0.00997. So we know the concentration of hydrogen ion, which is equal to the concentration of fluoride, and the concentration of hydrofluoric acid is 0.150 minus that, 0.140 or so. And the pH is 2.00. Now, here's the new part. Let's add some potassium fluoride to this solution that's already at equilibrium. Let's say we add 4.65 grams of potassium fluoride, which ends up being about 0.08 moles. And because it's 1 liter of solution, that means the concentration we've added is 0.08 molar. So what's going to happen? Well, you know already about Le Chatelier's principle, right? If we disturb the equilibrium by adding something on this side, we know it's going to shift over to this side. But we can do a little bit better than that. Now we can do the calculations. So because we know it's going to shift to this way, you can calculate Q, which would be a good thing. And you'd see that that also will predict that the equilibrium will shift back to the left. We start with now our initial concentration of hydrofluoric acid is what we just calculated, 0.140 molar. Hydrogen ion is what we calculated. Fluoride, though, is what we calculated plus what we put in there from the potassium fluoride. So we get this for the initial concentration of fluoride. And because we know it's going to go back over this way, we're going to add X to hydrofluoric acid and subtract it from these two guys right here. And so we get our equilibrium concentrations in terms of X. Plug into the Ka expression. Remember, this is Ka. Solve the quadratic. We get two roots. We can throw this out because it's too big. We can't lose more than we had to start with, right? So we know X. Now I can figure out the new equilibrium concentrations of everything in there and the new pH. When we do that, concentration of fluoride ion, it's 0.0812 or so. Hydrogen ion, 0.0011. And hydrofluoric acid, 0.149. And the new pH is 2.94. We've raised the pH by adding a common ion. So the common ion effect, it's really just a quantitative application of Le Chatelier's principle. When you add a strong electrolyte that has as one of its components an ion that's in an equilibrium, it shifts to the other side.